Okay, we're gonna load up one of my favorite games here. Here we have The End Is Nigh. It's a classic old school platforming game, and you know, it's one of my favorites. One of my favorite games. You got your classic controls, you got your jumping, you got your what? Oh shit! Oh no! No! No, 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 no! No! Oh fuck! Oh fuck! Oh god, no, this can't be broke. Here, let me get the cartridge out. Oh no, it's still not working. Oh fuck! Fuck, what am I gonna do? Fuck! Dear anybody reading this, I'm probably dead. That wouldn't be surprising. Everybody else is. There was some kind of apocalypse, and then all that was left was me. Well, most of me. All in all, you know, hasn't been so bad. Till yesterday. My favorite game cartridge finally broke. So I think I'm gonna go out and make a friend. I'll have to go out there. Outside. It's a dangerous, twisted place for death, decay, and... well, death, mostly. But you know what? Imagine all the fun we'll have, me and my friend, you know? Collecting tumors, spitting teeth for distance. Hey, you know, if I do it right, repopulate the world. It won't be easy, but I have nothing left to lose, except my other eye. Oh well, fuck it!
The End Is Nigh is the game that we're looking at today. Now, a lot of the times, you know, people throw around the word, oh, this is the Dark Souls of this genre, and so on and so forth. And at one point, Super Meat Boy was called the Dark Souls of the platforming genre. Basically, when somebody says X is the Dark Souls of X, they usually just mean it's really goddamn hard for this series of games. But I'd say this is probably one of the more apt games you could say is the Dark Souls of a series, because it is quite dark, but with a little bit of humour in it, obviously, as you just saw there. There was a little bit of humour thrown in with that, but it is quite dark, as you can see from the visuals and hear from the music, and by the fact that literally everybody's dead, and you. All that's pretty much all that's left is you, a mutated human into a blob. Quickly I want to get out the things that I don't like about this game. The grabbing can be a little bit iffy sometimes, and there will be times when you could have sworn that you should have grabbed onto the edge and you didn't. Yeah, that will happen from time to time. Other complaints, before I continue on, I was using the Pro controller I did a review of yesterday with the turbo button, and the turbo button is still a bit buggy. Like, even if you turn it off, it doesn't fix this, but, R2 and L2 and those buttons, they just keep on being spammed, so. And at a point in this game, I do just continuously hang off the edge. So later on, I do switch out the Pro Controller for my wired Pro Controller anyway. But yeah. I could have sworn there's one more thing about this game I didn't like. I can't think of it right now. If I remember it later, I'll tell you, but... So yeah, this is obviously a platformer. There are edges you can cling to, like, you know, these sticky outer bits that you can see on the walls here. And not the spikes. That's what I was going to play about. Sometimes in games, you will die just by touching the side of the spikes. Now, I really hate it when games do that, because it really doesn't make much sense if you just like even slightly touch the side of a spiky die. I think it should only be like if you land on top of the spiky die, but this isn't much of a deal breaker, it's just a mild annoyance. And it has caused me quite a few deaths. So if you play the Super Meat Boy, like I mentioned earlier, you would like this if you like Super Meat Boy, because like Super Meat Boy, this is quite challenging, and this will definitely occupy a lot of your time. Like, I don't even know how long I spent on this. I spent quite a while on this. Yeah, still going. I'm just scrolling down. There is quite a bit of this video. You can already tell by how long the video is. Pardon me. I spent a while just like trying to get through this. I will admit that I do die a lot in this video, in the video game, because this is a hard game, and I struggle in Super Mario Galaxy in some places. Especially in the last Galaxy, but Galaxy 2 is not regarded as a hard, even Mario game. It's not even regarded as a hard game, and this is quite hard. But even though I'm not good, I grew up being told if at first you don't succeed, try and try again. And mixed that with me just being extremely stubborn because my mum and my sister and also my brother are all stubborn, and so is my granddad on my mum's side of the family. We're all quite stubborn, so I'm not usually one to give up on a challenge, especially in a video game. I can definitely say that this game is not frustrating, because it throws stupid like game mechanics or shitty controls at you. It's frustrating. Well, it's not usually frustrating, but when I did get frustrated, I got frustrated because I knew I could do it, and it was just my lack of skills that were preventing me from doing it. So that just made me even more determined to get past it. I think I do the first two areas and stop after the second one. There's not really that much bullshit in this game. Like I said, spikes killing you from their sides. Again, I don't like that, but it's not too bad. And sometimes you don't grab onto the sides of a wall, which is also a bit frustrating, but again, not too bad. I definitely suggest picking this game up. I think it's on sale. I don't know how much it's on sale for, but definitely pick it up while it's on sale. And that goes for any of the other games. I try to do the cheaper games first, and the games I love there. The only cheap game I didn't do first, I think, was something like Breaks Up for Losers. I'll just check on my Switch right now. It is. Here it is. BAFL Breaks Up for Losers. BAFL is just the abbreviation for it. Breaks Up for Losers. I think that was only like 89p or something like that. And that's the only really cheap one I haven't done in this month, and I think I might do that tomorrow, because I think October goes up to the 31st, so tomorrow I'll review that, because tomorrow will be the last day you can get these games on sale. So yeah, definitely pick up them. And if you want a tight budget, games I would suggest picking up that probably like Video Game Kid, The Ender's Nine maybe, and maybe Super Meat Boy. Young World was cool. Well, actually, everything that I've played, I would just suggest anything that I've played so far, like Night Terrors, I'll do the AFL Work Tomorrow, or like Video Game Kid, well, not Video Game, the Video Kid, Night, The Ender's Nine, Neon World, Night Terrors, and I'd suggest picking them up, and I'll do a review of the AFL Tomorrow, and then, I'll probably ignore, I don't know if I'm going to ignore my 1 week break to do these reviews, but, I might do, because, I do like to have my 1 week break at the beginning of the month, so I'll probably just take my 1 week break, and then start the reviews again, on the, 8th. Either way, the next one will be Cave Story Plus, then it'll be Super Meat Boy, and then it'll be Mega Man X Legacy Collection 1, then Mega Man X Legacy Collection 2. But by then, the sale would have long ended. But I'm still doing the reviews of them. Anyway. So yeah. This is not an easy game. This is a game you would get if you want to challenge yourself and push yourself to become better at platformers. So like if you're stuck in a specific platformer, you know, just like have a get this, try to get past a few levels. I remember this part caused me great difficulty. This is the type of game that you should push you further rather than, you know, give you an easy time. So, definitely pick it up if you're looking for something to challenge yourself. And that probably goes the same for Super Meat Boy. That's also on sale. I don't know how much, but I don't think it's as cheap as the rest of the games I've reviewed so far. And I know Mega Man X Legacy Collection 1 and 2 are only 11 quid on sale. Not too bad, and I was 5% off. I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm gonna go back to Stardew Valley and play some of that because I need a little break from platforming. I need a little bit more relax after that because it does get your heart pounding, and yeah, it is quite tempting. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.